Quantum computing offers the possibility of exponential speedups in certain types of calculations over what could ever be achieved on a classical computer. The basic difference between quantum and classical computers is how they manipulate information. In a classical computer, if you have a series of decisions, you can only make one set of decisions, one path in that decision space at a time. And in lots of problems, the number of decisions you need to make grows exponentially if they depend on each other. In a quantum system, you don't have to do one at a time. You can take both paths. And so you can consider the case, this is true and false. And then you can look at the consequence of that, true and false, and so on. And just like in a pachinko parlor, rather than taking one path down for that ball, in the quantum case, you can take all paths. And in the very end of the calculation, you use what's called quantum interference to collect your result about, say, the optimal route through that decision space. Quantum computing is hard. In order to do a calculation, we have to come in from the classical world, give the quantum system instructions without messing it up, and get it to come to some result. Quantum computing is still in its infancy. It's a bit like the early days of classical computing when the transistor was first developed. We have the basic building blocks, but we need to figure out how to put them together. And that challenge is something that spans many disciplines, from basic science to engineering, computation, high-performance computing, and applications. And the lab is a place where we have those capabilities, and so it's an ideal place to pursue this and move the field forward. Another key aspect of the lab that's relevant for this kind of work is that we have a mission. And so everything we're doing is geared towards realizing that mission. It means we have an objective. And that actually has a strong impact on how we perform the work and how we move it forward.
The main component of our quantum testbed is a superconducting aluminum quantum processor. What makes our quantum processor unique is its elegant simplicity. It is a resource-efficient design so that we get the most computational power and the smallest footprint. The rest of the system is designed so we can make the processor work. We put the processor inside a cryogen-free dilution refrigerator, and the compressor reduces the temperature inside the refrigeration tank to about 3 Kelvin. The electronics around our quantum testbed serve two purposes. The first is a classical to quantum converter so that we can ask our processor a question. The second is as a quantum to classical converter so we can see the answer to that question. Our quantum testbed didn't come configured. There isn't an instruction manual for how to put together a quantum computer. Instead, we use the lab's mission need to drive our unique design choices and all of the electronics that make up the quantum computing system.